Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, friends, welcome back to our channel. In this session I modified this power supply that we are taking 10.9 volts from the 12 volt section, and now I am increasing the voltage. The lamp is glowing. 12.34, 13 volt, 14 volt, 15.48 volt. It is 20 volt. At 20 volt it is stable. So I think it will much useful if we use from 11 volt to 20 volt, and it is regulated. It is maintaining the voltage. Let's start it and see how we can modify it. This is our third video in this ATX Power Supply series. In this session we will increase the output voltage of this power supply. First of all, I will recommend, please never play with any design, but this question is questioned many times, and if you want to modify it at your own responsibility. I will guide you in very easiest steps we can modify it. In my first video I discussed how you can remove the protection. For that purpose I told you that we need to install a jumper from pin 4 of TL494 to the ground. First of all we will see this power supply positive voltage at the ground. Now I am connecting this power supply to the line voltage. If you don't have a good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair. I connected green wire to the black wire and now it is power on. It is providing 12.32 volts. But when I will connect the load to 12 volts, this power supply is turned off. This is the first problem, that when there is load imbalance, I discussed practically in my last video for explaining protection circuit LM339. You can watch that video. I will demonstrate again. It is 12.32 volt. Now I will connect the load again. It is 75 watt load only, the car lamp. As I connected, it turned off. The protection circuit immediately disabled this IC. Now let's check the condition of pin number 4 of this TL494 or KA7500-1234. Now it is disabled. It need to be at ground level to work properly. Let me power it on again. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is working condition. This time we have output voltage 12.35 volts. That's nice. Now first of all we will make bypass. We will remove this protection. Connect pin number 4 of TL494 to the ground. That is our first step. 1, 2, 3, 4. It is safe. It will not make any damage. Now I will connect the load. Now this power supply is powered on and it is now connected to power supply, and now I will connect load to the 12 volt section. We bypassed the safety and now it is 11.7 volt. The voltage dropped. Why? The voltage are 12.33 volt. Why regulation is bypassed? Because when we are putting load at 12 volt, the other power supplies are also raising up. So the summing point voltage of three power supplies, 5 volt, 3.3 volt, are interrupting in the regulation. So now we need to disable that line, which are connected for sense line. Set multimeter to continuity. Now the power must be removed. Continuity. Connect to the 3.3 volt section and trace there are two lines coming here. One is this point, this is 3.3 volts, and check 5 volt. This is 5 volts. This line is reaching here at 5 volt, and this 3.3 volt, this section is reaching here. Here we have two resistors, one and two resistors, which are coming. So these are two resistors here, 5 volt and 3 volt. We will remove two resistors, this one from here. This side is connected to 5 volt and 3.3 volt. We will remove the second end, which is connected. Remove these two resistors. I removed these two resistors. Why? Because these are being added or subtracted from our sense line. So this line, it is coming 3.3 volt and 5 volt section. So I removed these resistors. And now we want to see from the same point, we have jumper here, which is connected to pin number 1. If we check the same, this point, it is connected through this jumper to the pin number 1. We want to remove this jumper. Remove it. That is here. This jumper removed from pin number 1 so that anything will not flow back to the remaining circuit. We disconnected this jumper. Two resistors from 5 volt and 3.3, and the same two resistors are connected to this jumper. So we remove this one as well. And there are now two resistors here. Leave them as it is at the same point. This is TL494 or KF7500. These two resistors remain connected. These are connected to 12 volts. In the next step, we need 10 kilo ohm potentiometer, 1 kilo ohm resistor, 10 kilo ohm resistor. Connect in this configuration. 10 kilo ohm, 10 kilo ohm potentiometer, the slider arm, and here 1 kilo ohm. Connect ground here, positive 12 volt here, and this wire we will connect to pin number 1 of this IC, that is this point. This is the slider arm of the potentiometer. You can use this power supply as a bench power supply for different other projects, whatever you want. Now I will take two lines, the positive and the ground. Positive output 12 volt and the ground. Now we are going to stabilize just only 12 volt section, because our main focus is at 12 volt section, because many comments are being received that we want to adjust it for battery charger, for bench power supply. This is here and this one is here. Ground. So these are the connections. Ground to 1 kilo ohm resistor, 12 volt to 10 kilo ohm resistor, slider to pin number 1 of this IC. Let's now check it. And we will connect load. I will connect multimeter to monitor the voltage. Ground and 12 volt. So our multimeter is connected here now at 12 volt section. Now what we need to do, we need to replace this capacitor. Here it is 16 volt capacitor. We need at least 25 or 35 volt capacitor, and other capacitors we will remove because we don't need that sections. We are just only taking output from 12 volt. Adjust it. 13 volt, 16 volt, 21 volt. So it is enough. From 11 volt to upward, we can do it. Now if I will connect, because this time I am using series lamp, if I will connect load, series lamp will glow. So now it is safe. We will use direct power supply to power it on. Now the same 11.05 volt. Let's connect the load. So it is 11 point, let me cover it. So it is 11.04 volts. Let's adjust it. 11.92. You can see the lamp is getting bright. 13 volts. And it is stable. 10.9. The lamp is getting bright. 14.5. 14 volt, and it is not turning off. 14.3 volt. So you can use it as a battery charger, whatsoever. So at 20 volt, 20.3 volt, it is good, and it is too much bright. If this video is good, you can like it. If you think it is helpful, it is useful, you can share it with your friends. And if you have any question, please let me know in the comment box. Now we need to remove these capacitors, and we will just only leave here one capacitor. Other capacitors we need to remove it, because when the voltage will increase, the other power supplies will increase, and any capacitor will blast, and we will increase the voltage rating of that capacitor. That is, this time it is 16 volt. We need to install a good capacitor with at least same capacitance, that is in 12 volt section, but the voltage rating must be higher than this one, because our maximum voltage may reach up to 20 volt. So it is 500 microfarad, 16 volt. I am using 1000 microfarad, 35 volt. So that will more good. Take care for the polarity, negative to negative, positive to positive, and install it here. This is the very important point of safety. Otherwise it will damage. We will remove the other two capacitors. If you want to use the other sections as well, you can also increase the capacitor value for that sections, but this time I am just only using this one, 12 volt section. So we removed all capacitors. Let's check it now. And the final check, place this potentiometer at any convenient place in the power supply. This ground, 12 volt. First I will connect without load and then we will apply load. It is 11.04 volt and I am connecting load, so it is the same, 11.0504, does not matter, it is good. Now we can increase the voltage. We can see the intensity of the lamp is increasing now. It is 15 volt and stable. That's nice. If this video is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. If you think this video is informative for you, please share it with your friends so maybe someone can take benefit from this one. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.